Friends, welcome to the lecture series of Analog Electronics. Today we are going to learn about the frequency response, right? We have already understood that what do we exactly mean by frequency response, but today we are going to derive the equation for the frequency response, which will be helpful to understand the active filters. Why? Because it will be using that term into the particular active filter gain and the transfer function values of that particular filter. So let's understand. For the sake of our understanding, we are taking one operational amplifier which is basically represented in a particular form like this way, and it will be having some internal resistance. So that is our internal resistance Ri. Here are the two terminals. We can namely give their names as like V2 and V1, and here is our input, here is our output over here. Kind of capacitor is attached over here, and that will be earthed towards the downside, and this one is also earthed. From here we will take the output, right? So for the equation, that is the output equation, we can say, so we can write this thing that VO is equals to minus JXC. This is our capacitor, and for this capacitor term we are writing that is our minus JXC divided by the input. Whatever the input is at the particular this value, so we are writing that thing at over here. This particular represents the AOL, that means open loop gain of the operational amplifier, multiplied by the differential voltage. So that is the basic phenomena of our operational amplifier that we have already understood. For this term, we can write this thing that Ri minus JXC and multiplied by AOL into Vd. So this term is nothing but the basic output equation of the operational amplifier, whichever is applicable to the operational amplifier. So from this particular equation we can write XC is equals to 1 divided by 2 pi FC. We can write this thing for the XC. So putting these values into the XC, we can write this thing as 1 divided by 2 pi FC. In place of this XC, we are writing this thing divided by RO plus J into 1 divided by 2 pi FC. Okay, so this will be our second equation. So now what we are doing, that we are considering the open loop gain, which is the function of the frequency, can be denoted as an A. So I am writing the thing that let the open loop gain, which is the function of frequency, can be denoted as A. That is our amplitude, or we can say the A, that is our name of this particular gain, right? So we can write this thing as an A is equals to VO divided by VD. So basically what we are writing, that the equation which is completely at this side, we are considering only the values which is being produced due to the operational amplifier, and we are writing this equation as an A is equals to VO divided by VD and AV divided by 1 plus J into 2 pi F RO into C. So this way it can be represented. Now what we are doing, that F1 is considered as 1 divided by 2 pi RO into C, and this equation can be represented in this way also, that 2 pi ROC is nothing but equals to 1 by F1. So substituting this value into the equation, we can write A is equals to AV divided by 1 plus J into F divided by F1. So this way it can be represented. Here the frequency, that is F, is denotes the input frequency of the supply voltage, and this frequency will denote the frequency of the particular operational amplifier which is being produced at the output terminals. And one more thing, that is our A. A is nothing but open loop voltage gain. Open loop voltage gain. And here the AV represents the open loop voltage gain at F is equals to 0 hertz. Whenever the frequency will be 0 hertz, at that time whatever the voltage gain is available is denoted by this term, or we can say the AV or AOL. We can write this AV as an AOL also. So it's okay if you write AOL. In starting we have AOL, so you can continue that with that, and you can use that term also instead of this AV. So to find out the magnitude plot, that what will be the magnitude of this output waveform, then we must write this thing as an mod A is equals to AOL, or we can say the AV divided by under root 1 plus F upon F1 whole square. Right? So this way it can be represented. And if we need to write the phase plot, then phase plot can be represented in this way, that phi is equals to tan inverse F divided by F1. So there will be two cases, two different cases. The first case we are taking as F is very very much less than F1, then the magnitude of gain mode A is 20 log AOL, or we can write AV decibel, right? So this way the magnitude of gain can be represented. For the second case, if F is equals to F1, then at the corner frequency, it can be represented. So this way the second case. Now after that, third case, F is very very much greater than the F1, then the gain mode A rolls off at a rate of -20 डेसिबल पर डिकेड और -6 डेसिबल पर ऑक्टेन. सो दिस वे इट विल स्टार्ट डिक्रीजिंग. Either it will be in -20 decibel per decade or it will be in the form of -6 decibel per decade. So this way our frequency response can be described or we can say denoted. So first of all of you need to remember these two equations that is not provided in your book, but at least you have some of the idea that how it can be derived. So that's why I have taken this, but all of you need to remember this thing for the derivation of our active low pass filters. So this way it can be represented, and like this way it can be obtained for the magnitude plot and the phase plot. So that's all for this frequency response. After that we are going to discuss about the first order low pass filter, right? First order low pass Butterworth filter. So if you have gained some of your knowledge from this video, then at least you can like and share my video. And if you want to see more this kind of videos, then do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.